And now let's learn about other property regarding the CSS borders. This one is called border radius. Ever since we revealed the borders of boxes, you may have noticed that the borders highlight the true shape of an element's box square. Thanks to CSS, a border doesn't have to be square. You can modify the corners of an element's border box with the border radius property. And here is the property. The code in the example above will set all four corners of the border to a radius of 5 pixels. The same curvature that a circle with a radius of 5 pixels would have. You can create a border that is a perfect circle by first creating an element with the same width and height, and then setting the radius equal to the distance between the center of the circle and the width of the box, which is 50%. Okay, the code in the example above creates a div that is a perfect circle. So we have height of 60 pixels, width of 60 pixels too. Then we have a border of 3 pixels, solid, and this is the color. I'm not sure what color it is. And we have a border radius set to 50 pixels, so we will have a perfect circle. The code in the example above creates a div that is a perfect circle. Let's see the instructions. In style CSS, set the border radius of banner content h1 to 15 pixels. So same element like in the previous video. So let's set its border radius to 15 pixels. Yep, I got a mistake here. Now pay attention. You see, now we have a border radius on all four sides. Try experimenting with other border radius values and running your code to see the results. And now let's try 55 pixels and pay attention to corners. And this is larger radius. Let's try this. We have a width of 400 pixels for this h1. Let's try and let's set the height to 400 pixels. Again, I made a spelling mistake. And now let's set border radius to 50%. We have same width and height. And now we should get a circle. And you see, we got the circle. I know the text is overlapping the borders, but that's not important now. Just pay attention to the element itself and its borders and its border radius. So this is how you get the perfect circle. And that should be all for this exercise. Let's move on.